Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
Today's Bhagavad Gita satsang. Having given up the clinging for the reward of performance with a constant feeling of satisfaction without depression on anything, though engaged in execution, he does not even do a little action. Having given up the clinging for the reward of performance with a constant feeling of satisfaction without depression, dependence on anything. Pick up that, bring that exact English word, Sanskrit word. Nirashrayaha. Please understand. Karma bala sangam nityatrupto nirashrayaha. Nirashraya. Ashraya means the excitement. Nirashraya means depression. Ashraya means the excitement which comes by the acharati. by the nearness. For example, if I bring the sweet near my tongue, the excitement the tongue feels. If you bring some visuals which your eyes like, when you bring it near eyes, the excitement the eyes feel. If you love somebody, if you come near that person or that person comes near you, the excitement you feel. These are all called ashraya. But all this excitement leads to depression. Excitement by any nearness leads to depression. The excitement just by yourself, like Dakshinamurti, Swatmananda, just by your very presence, you are excited. And I don't see any rich items around him. And with all this, his eyes are closed. But he is in bliss. Means there is nothing from outside is necessary to excite him. See, he is not Vishnu. See, Vishnu, if you see, there is so much to get excited. Ocean of milk and the beautiful Ananta Sayana, the bed of Adisesha. Snake bed. See, maybe snake is bad because he has a poison. Otherwise, as a bed, he must be very comfortable. And the Miss Universe, Lakshmi, is pressing the feet. And all the Shamantaka, all the best pearls and gems and diamonds, Parijata, and all the time lying. Nothing to be done. Nirashraya means being in Swatmananda without depression. Having given up the clinging for the reward of performance with a constant satisfaction without depression. Though engaged in execution, he does not do even a little action. Each word. Please understand very beautifully, Bhagavan says, though engaged in execution, he does not do even a little action. And what is the meaning of execution and action? Execution means establishing a consciousness and seeing that everything flows as per the consciousness. Action means every day, doing every inch. Any number of hours I work, I never feel I am doing an action, that there is an action from me. Understand, execution means establishing a consciousness and seeing the whole flow. If you also want to be out of action, become part of this consciousness, then you will see action happens through you, but you are not even feeling that the action is happening. Desire for name and fame is obviously known. Inside you, without even you knowing, there will be undercurrent of desire. That is what is called clinging. I'll give up all my desire for name and fame, but will I be praised for that? See, this man doesn't desire for name and fame at all. Will people tell that word to me? That is clinging. People can give up their desire for name and fame. If they are assured for that, they will be praised later on. That is what is called clinging. Bhagavan is going to the depth of your mind. He says, clinging for the reward of performance with a constant feeling of satisfaction, fulfilled, without depression, though engaged in execution, he does not even do a little action. Means he's just there in ecstasy. No action touches him. He's not touched by any action. Understand, executing without feeling you are acting is the quality of a leader.
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city. is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Answer some of your questions. Sudha, she's asking from Chicago, USA. What are the three main steps the parents can do at home to groom the child in Vedic way? How to choose the schools for my child? Sudha, if you are honest, you know you don't have much options in USA. If you are really sincere and honest, I'll give you three steps. First step, book a ticket to Biridi. Second step, admit the child in Gurukul. Third step, don't come back again for the next 7 years. Please understand. No, really. See, Vasishtha in Vasishtha Gurukula, Dasaratha and Kaushalya and Kaikeyi and Sumatra, all four of them are too attached to their four kids. Even in imagination, I have never seen the better imagination than Ramayanam family. God. What a cultured people, the Raghuvamshis, the Suryavamshis. The Suryavamshis are the best people on the planet Earth. So naturally, these guys are stable family people. See, people of stable family, the love was so strong, Dasaratha and the parents, they were not able to handle when the kids went to Gurukul with Vasishta. But as a law, they have to go to the Gurukul to study. You will be shocked. 7 years, Vasishta did not allow the parents to see the kids even once. Dasaratha is supposed to be the king. He can straight enter into the Gurukul and see the kids. But those kings are nice people. Straight, he could have entered. No. Finally, once they are not able to control. So, Dasaratha goes to Vasishta Gurukul in the name of donating 1,000 cows. And Vasishta stops Dasaratha in the entrance, takes the donation and sends him back. Sends all the 4 back. He says, no, 7 years, you have no right over the child. Between 7 to 14, child should not see parents. That is the, you see, either go to this extreme, they should completely grow with you. You also behave like a guru. Like, I always say that they should be sleeping, even sleeping in your lap. Go to that, because now the gurukuls are not available, I am giving you that option. But if you are really, really, really authentic, see, if you are honest about your child's future, go for this option. Let it sleep in your lap and you personally groom. Stop going for job. If you want to go for job, why did you give birth to a child? See, I am very clear about my life. I have too much of work. So I have decided no kids, no marriage in my life. Same way, if you think you have too much of work, then why did you get married? Why did you give birth to a child? Why are you wasting somebody else's life? You work, make money, have a vacation, go and lie down in any beach you want. Enjoy. The problem is without capacity, you are trying to play all the dimensions. Just because you can get pregnant and deliver a child, don't think you can become a mother. Just because you can do dash, 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 don't think you can become a father. So be very clear. Parenting is a separate art. It's not a joke. You are playing literally with one person's life. Are even to attend a small disease, stomach pain or knee pain, you need to study 6 years and get that MBBS. You have to get that MBBS, only then you can even give a small medicine. This is not those old days. You have to continuously give birth 3 in 2 years. Come on, Sudha, you need to look in honestly and authentically. You can't do much in US. There are second level options. We have our Vedic schools and N Vidyalayas, the internet, even we also have N Vidyalaya. Just through internet you can bring up your child, homeschooling, all these are there. But everything is a poor substitute.
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो लाइव किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे.
That's great. Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
आठ से प्रारंभ. कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0800-272-7999 पर फोन करेंगे, वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं. लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social-emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious Program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings. Actually, I was wondering why Vasishtha was so hard on Dasaratha, because Vasishtha knows Dasaratha did not have a child for a long time. For a long time he did not have a child. Almost when he was old only he had a child. When Dasaratha had a child, he was at least above 70. He was above 70. Only then he had a child, and only at that time he had a child. You may ask, how is it possible biologically? In those days it was possible. With some herbs and medicines they have done, that is different. So Dasaratha did not have a child for a long time. After that he had a child, and Vasishtha also knows the child is God himself. So why Vasishtha was so cruel, that's the right word, cruel for Dasaratha? I went through Manusmriti, then I saw that 7 years, if they are completely with the master, the whole bio memory becomes master's bio memory. The parents' bio memory doesn't get into the system. The disconnection happens. So child becomes completely new and alive. That is the reason. Even in our Gurukula, I insist that they spend less time in their homes and less time with their parents. See, if they want their inheritors, then they can keep them in the house itself. Bring them up just like you, or bring them down just like you. If you want them to be a real enlightened beings, 7 to 14, just disconnect. Say that this 7 years, I will not disturb the child. Sudha, I am giving you 3 main steps. First step, step out of your house, go to the airport. Second, put the child in the Gurukul. Third, don't come back for 7 years to see the child. You can come back to see me, but not the child. Even if you come with 1,000 cows, I'll stand in the welcome center itself, take the 1,000 cows and send you back, as Vasishtha did. Come on, next question. Samar Jain is asking, Swamiji, in yesterday's satsang, I loved the way you compared decision making to a workout. I enjoy taking challenges, but frequently get stressed out in the process. Is this stress healthy, like the sweet pain we get after a workout? First thing, I wanted to make it very clear. Any stress is healthy when you accept stress. Please understand, stress is unhealthy only when you have the concept you may bust at some point. If you feel, if you believe, if I accumulate more and more stress, at some point I may bust. No. Stress is disease based on belief. If you are very clear, no amount of stress is going to make you bust. Stress is not like a steam. Understand? See, you visualize stress is like a steam. More steam, more steam, more steam. One day the boiler will explode. No. Every night when you sleep, boiler is emptied again. Every sleep is a stress buster. So how much you can build within one day? Nothing. You are not that intelligent. Even your stress building level is only mediocre level. Understand? It is wrong. Ideas about stress needs to be bust first. Stress busting is nothing but busting the wrong ideas you carry about stress. I wanted to make it very clear. These are all called modern day scientific myths. Myths from the psychology. Superstitions from psychiatry. Superstitions promoted by Sigmund Freud and Jung. The theory of unconsciousness. Theory of accumulating the stress. I tell you, I'm defining you the beauty. Beauty is the feeling you carry when somebody appreciates you. Please understand, I am defining in the mundane level, not in the spiritual level. I am defining in the mundane level. Beauty is the feeling you carry when somebody appreciates you. Means if somebody says, oh, you look great, then the feeling you carry is beauty for you. And same way, when you make somebody else to have that same feeling about them, in them, it is beauty for that person. Please understand.
Discover the power of Kundalini Awakening at Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational program blessed personally by Rare Living Incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. What is Kundalini? Kundalini is the tremendous potential energy hidden inside every individual, which can be awakened through initiation by an enlightened master. Once awakened, Kundalini has the power to transform every area of your life and bring you health, wealth, success, joyful relationships and spiritual enlightenment. Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening at Kalpataru. Manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyanapetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
Concept of beauty is nothing but give and take. There is no such thing as standard scale, but this cosmetic industry creates the concept of beauty and keeps it alive continuously. What is actually beauty? Nothing. Just the ideas promoted widely. That's all. And wildly. That's it. There's nothing else called beauty. Even if somebody is so beautiful, all right, you are lost in that person. You can't drink one cup of tea through that mouth. Don't you understand? You can't drink even one cup of tea through that mouth. What is beauty? It is just the concept you create. Just like how the cosmetics industry keeps the disease that you are ugly alive by doing the beauty contest. Same way, the mental health care industry keeps the idea that you are, if you are stressed, you will be sick alive to keep their industry alive. Enlightened being is the only person who breaks the idea that you are unenlightened, and in that way he keeps himself alive. Understand? An enlightened being never keeps himself alive by saying you can't be enlightened. Constantly he says you are already enlightened. Through that way he keeps himself alive. The idea of stress, that if you accumulate stress you will be suffering, is wrong. Understand? Your ideas about stress need to be bust first. The moment you understand this, the pain will really become sweet pain, and after that, even in the sweet pain, the pain will disappear, just only the sweetness will remain. Pain becomes sweet pain, and in the sweet pain, pain disappears and sweet remains. So continue to make decisions continuously. Take challenges. You see, it's like today you lift 10 kg, and once your muscles are built, then you will be able to lift 20 kg. Same way, take the decisions to exhaust your confidence. Have courage to exhaust your confidence. The next day, you will have more courage and more confidence. Take better decisions. Don't say, today if I lift 10 kg dumbbells, then I'll be tired once for all. From tomorrow, I'll never be able to lift. I would have exhausted all my energy. No. Next day, you'll have more energy to lift 15 kg or 20 kg. You should always lift and work out the free dumbbells, because always the fear you may drop on you is there. You will do it properly. If it is a machine, then you will always have a casual way and you will not be doing it sincerely. That is why I am saying, be always an individual entrepreneur. Don't be a manager in somebody else's machine. If you are in somebody else's machine, manager, then working out will not work out for you. Because all the risk you take is inside the boundary given to you. It's not life and death risk. Because finally, somebody else is responsible. Only when you are an entrepreneur, this whole philosophy of taking decisions on your own works out. Working out in the machine is like you being a part of some company and doing this game. Working out with dumbbells means you being responsible for yourself completely. That is why with dumbbells you will always be able to only lift less weight. With machine you will lift more weight. Reason is you feel safe, secured. But the challenge of life is in the game of insecurity. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974220331. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.